Hi guys, I'm Bharath Kulkarni. I'm studying in Hubli. I'm studying in K Technological University, majoring in Electronics and Communication. I got a total of band 8 in IELTS with 9 in reading and 8.5 in listening. I had a 7 in writing and 7.5 in speaking. Yes, I wrote my GRE 4 days prior to my IELTS on the 11th of September. The plan to actually do a master's started quite before I even joined my engineering. My cousin motivated me to look up options after my graduation as an engineer, and I started looking up all the new trends in our in the current technological world. It started from IoT to deep electronics, and also to machine learning, computer science, artificial intelligence. And I didn't know much about it back then. As and when I started studying and getting through my engineering, I realized that computer science is something that is really interesting to me. And I looked up a few courses on Coursera, and I started taking them. In the initial stages, it was a little tough. And then as and when it progressed, I started to develop an interest. So that is how my wish or an ambition to pursue a master's came to be. And why abroad? I think there are more chances abroad, and the reward, or I get to travel the world and study and also work abroad and get to know different cultures, and it will give me an exposure and I think help me become a better human, develop my personality as such. So that is why I prefer doing a master's abroad. So this happened back in 6th semester. We were just near the end of the semester when I heard there was a workshop from the Baiju's people, and Mr. Santosh had come in there, and he gave us a preview of how the RCs go on and how Baiju's will help us. And they also showed us how we can get into scholarships or different colleges. I was interested from the day one, and I again had follow-up sessions with a few consultants at Baiju's, and then I signed up 15 days after the workshop. I took some time to understand the Baiju's GRE course. At first, I just was watching webinars on every evening. I started pretty slow over there, and then I got the hang of membane software to learn the vocabulary, and then I started using the tab. So when I was using the tab, the most helpful part was the RC principles, reading comprehension principles session of the tab, and then came the quantitative topics. Each topic had at least 2 hours of videos, and there were many examples that could be solved in each topic. And also, if I wanted, I could create a test for myself on the topics I wanted. So that is really the adaptive question bank. So that also helped me a lot. And when it comes to RCs, they taught me more than just how to answer the questions. I got to learn about American history. I got to learn about art in the 18th century, 19th century. And it was a really nice exposure, I can say. And Bean software really helped me. I used to do 1.5 hours of maybe every day. And towards the end, it came down to 2 hours each day. And it is fun when you start answering questions. It's pretty interactive as a software. And also, the practice passages in the tab itself were enough for me to cover up the verbal part, and even text completion and all the other topics. The tab really helped me. That is where everything is. And then I jumped to the GRE book to do a few other questions from ETS. So the IELTS courses started on, for me, it started as a webinar on every Friday evening. It used to be just once a week, and it was just a couple of hours each week. And then the pace increased. I started practicing IELTS papers from the portal, and then I went on to there was a workshop for us for around a week in Hubli. People, trainers from Baiju's had come down to Hubli, and they were very friendly. Even for the GRE, we had a workshop in Hubli for 15 days. So throughout, the experience was good. They helped us. They gave us worksheets. And even if we spent like 6-7 hours straight with them, we didn't feel tired at the end of the day. They gave us a nice interactive session throughout. And as per the IELTS, I like the speaking part the most, where we were given worksheets, and we actually had a personal mock interview when we were doing the workshop in Hubli. with regard to the writing section also, we were given templates and we were practicing as to how we can write well. Yeah, that's pretty much it. The IELTS program basically was simpler than the GRE verbal part, so that's why I think I sailed smoothly through IELTS part of the coaching. Yeah, that helped me. All the faculty were really good. It was, you know, very flexible. I could sit in the night, till late night, and do how many videos I wanted, and I could replay, rewind, and take my time to understand. That is the best part of the tablet mode. But since you have the tablet, you may tend to get lazy and just procrastinate, but that's a different side of it. But I really felt the tablet was helpful because I had all the content readily available at the touch of my finger. I had it and I could solve whatever I wanted. I could watch a video n number of times, and I think that's how the tablet helped me. The best strategy which I used in the IELTS was in the reading part, where we had to read just the first and the last line of each paragraph and get the gist of it. So that really helped me. We have 1 hour to finish the three passages in IELTS. I finished it in 40 minutes. So for the other 20 minutes, I was just going through, you know, looking for mistakes, and that's how I got full nine, band nine in reading. As per listening, ma'am had told us to make notes parallelly by listening to the audio file, and that also helped me. If I had made any mistake, I could just like look back and write the correct answer. As for writing, we had the templates, so the templates made a big difference. We didn't have to think on how to start, how to create the body, how to end it. We just had to put in the points which needed more attention, like the issue at hand needed more attention rather than the template. So the template helped a lot, and in speaking, yeah, it comes with practice, and the strategies in speaking were pretty common. Like you had to practice. The more you practice, the better you speak. That was the strategy for speaking. So the best effect I had from the best strategy, that tips and tricks that I learned from Bhaijun, and that helped me throughout my exam. So when it comes to verbal part, especially, there are many the RC principles part or RC rules sessions. They help, like they were the backbone to what I've got today, the score I've got today in both the exams. And some of them were like reading the first and the last paragraph to understand the gist of the whole passage, or it would be reading the first and the last line of each paragraph to understand what is the whole content, because sometimes it gets redundant reading the whole paragraph and trying to answer a particular question. So those two really helped me a lot. And if it comes down to understanding the main theme of the passage, again, we just had to look into a couple of paragraphs in in certain passages there were like 12 paragraphs, but the main thing would be just within two paragraphs. So the time it took for me to understand where my answer lies was cut short dramatically. So yeah, this is one of the best strategy that helped me in the verbal part. When it comes to the aptitude part of it, there were again a couple of shortcuts in numeric entry questions. You just have to solve the entire thing, but if you have multiple correct answer choices, you can start from the middlemost value and then decimate, looking at how it works out. Like most of the questions, the answers are arranged in an increasing order numerically, so you can just like if your answer doesn't fit, you can test on a shorter set of options. So that was one thing that helped me in the exam. I actually used this in the exam. So my test day experience was more or less like a roller coaster ride. I like on the day of the test, I couldn't have my breakfast. I was like choking on the food, and I had a bad time. Like this is at 8 a.m. and I'm a little nervous. I don't know why. But yeah, I couldn't have a complete breakfast. So it started that way, and then I went to the test building, and the environment was quite, I can say, silent. You know, everyone was a little shaky. There were just like 20 other kids with me, and so we were all like pretty much everyone was quiet, and we were all nervous, I can say. We had to fill out a couple of forms before entering the hall, and then came the intense checking. All the checking of passport and also they check you a lot because they don't want you to carry any devices and any malpractice, to avoid any malpractice. And then came the first part, and that's when I remembered the words told in every AWA section: take this 1 hour to calm down, you know, just like streamline your thoughts. With, because of the template, this helps a lot. The template is pretty similar for each essay. So just, you know, streamline your thoughts on the issue at hand, and just like sail through the first 1 hour. And that's what I did. I, you know, the first 1 hour set the mood for the next 3 hours. And then I got 3 quantitative and 2 verbal. And when I started, it was pretty easy. The first sections are always easy. And then after the third section, I went for a break. I had a few, this break is pretty important. And I suggest you can suggest everyone to take the break. It's just a walk and a little, you know, a little breather. It acts like a little breather from all the intense thinking from inside. The whole environment is a little too strict. Like, there are cameras every other computer you sit at. There are cameras everywhere in the hallway, in the exam room, outside, in the waiting area. So it's pretty much like you're being scrutinized for every action you do. So I took the break and we calmed down, and then came the other 3 sections. When it was time to look at my score, I didn't know what to expect because I was already the actual exam, no matter how many mock tests you take, the actual exam is always different. Like, I took close to 9 or 10. I was still in my comfort zone. I was sitting in my room and doing the mock test, but this is a little different. And the mock test did help, but the actual GRE exam is a little different. That's what I felt. When the time to see the scores came up, I was not prepared to see my score, actually. And then I see, you know, 313, and I'm a little disappointed and all stuff. And we have to send the scores to schools, because there are again 2 categories in that, for undergraduates and for graduates. There's a change which the GRE people, the ETS people, come and help you in that process. And after I went in at around 10 o'clock and came out at 2:30-ish. And it was a mix of feelings, you know, there's a relief, and then, you know, like, you're done with the hard part of it, and then comes the next part of applying to schools and whatnot. But yeah, the GRE is the first milestone that you need to cross, and it was a nice experience, I can say. Audience would be that if you are planning for your GRE, like in my case, I had placements versus GRE. So I put in 60 days of, I was off all social media. That's the first thing you need to do, because once your people around you will be enjoying in the time you're preparing for GRE, because it's usually either in the holidays before your SEM starts, or I don't know what it is for the working people, but for students, it's usually in the holidays. For me, it was. So I went off social media first, and then I started working reading speed, because that is really important even in GRE, because it's a time-based test. After all, you have just 35 minutes, and you have at least 3 passages to read through, and you need to improve your reading capability, and you need to improve your concentration. These 60 days helped me improve myself as a person. Like, I got to know a better side of me that worked hard. And also throughout this experience, the Membeam software really helps. It helps you in the long run too, not only for the GRE exam. You have a better vocabulary, you have a better set of skills right after the exam and after the process. And Byju's really helps you if you have a mail, even if you have a problem, like even a small issue, and you just put out a mail, it will be responded to at least within the next 12 hours or the next working day. And that is how it was for me. Every issue I faced, I sent out a mail, and there was always someone who used to call me or send out a mail saying, is the issue resolved? And I think Byju's was a better option for me, because I could do all this sitting at home. I'm not from Bangalore, so I didn't have to go all the way to Bangalore and, you know, sit in the classroom sessions and all that stuff. I was in Hubli, in my house, in my hometown, and I got the same facilities that any other person in close access to these classes would have, and that is one thing. So yeah, that's pretty much. Just concentrate, and all the best for your journey. My IELTS was like every IELTS exam has the same timeline. The exam starts, the registration starts at 11:30. The exam starts at 1 and roughly ends at 4 o'clock. So you can so during this is unlike GRE. You don't have a specified break in the IELTS exam. You have to enter before 12:30 the exam hall. You need to enter the exam hall at before 12:30. And the first section is always listening, so they check your mics, they check your headsets, you need to be ready with your answer scripts. Like after every section, sometimes they take both the papers, the answer sheet and the question paper. Sometimes they just keep the question paper and give you a new answer sheet. So all that happens. And I suggest eating, like this was a suggestion given by Monica ma'am also, and I personally suggest, you know, eating just like Snickers maybe just before entering your registration part of the exam, because that will carry on until 4 o'clock. You cannot eat anything. Water, however, will be provided, and they also provide for breaks during the exam, but there's a trade-off between you losing your time and taking the break. So yeah, that is pretty much it.